Today is 11th January 2023 and I'm going to conduct your ELLT, which is also known as Oxford test. So could you please tell me your full name? Would you please tell me your full name?
Sir, my full name is Muhammad Umar and you can call me simply.
All right, that is fine. Where are you from, Mr. Umar? Where are you from?
I am basically, sir, from Peshawar, which is the capital city of province Pakistan. It has the sixth most.
All right. Okay, that is fine. That's fine. So, you know, Mr. Umar, there are four sections. The first section, you haven't joined the audio. You have to click on the audio. Yes, now it is joined. Okay, Mr. Umar, you know, there are four sections. The first one would be introduction. The second one would be presentation. The third one would be essay, the essay which you have written and your writing task. And the last one would be picture description. So we shall begin the first one.
Yes.
So do you have any nickname?
Okay. I have no nickname, but you can simply call me Umar.
Okay, Mr. Umar, you know, yes. why do you want to go to the UK?
Sorry, sir, I can't pick your question.
I'm saying that why do you want to move to the UK?
Oh, okay, sir. Sir, I want to UK for a postgraduate studies because of the education system. You know, UK education system is very the level and the quality of education system is very better. Mm-hmm. And the other reason is that the education system is very short as compared to other countries, which is master for 1 year. And their education is completely practical rather than theoretical. So that there are two or three particular reasons I choose UK rather than other countries.
All right, that's great. Mr. Umar, could you please show me your identification?
Yes, sir.
Okay, no need to show me. Could you please show me your room?
Of course, sir. Why not?
Yes, you should show me. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. That's fine. Thank you.
Welcome, sir.
All right. So now the second part is the presentation which was given to you while you were booking your speaking. So you should start.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. I will now start my presentation, and my presentation topic is that UK faces homelessness issue in 2010. So is this issue is also facing in your country, and what could be done to combat this issue? So my answer is to the question is yes, homelessness is a very major issue experiencing in my country. In the recent research, there are about 20 million of people who are experiencing homelessness. That's our 20% of our population. It's an issue that affects all kind of ages, races, and genders. The causes of homelessness are very varied and complex, but the main causes of homelessness are poverty, unemployment, mental and health problem, natural disaster, and unaffordable houses. The consequences of homelessness are very far-reaching. It's not affect only the individual, but experiencing the homelessness, but it also affect the entire families and wider community. It can have an adverse effect on physical and mental health, education, job opportunities, criminal activities, suicide, and social relationships. Now, in order to combat this issue, there are some ranges that can be measured. Number first is the education process. So, you know, education is the very major role, play a major role, and it's a key to avoid homelessness. For example, if you have a high level of education, so even if you fire from an institution or any other authorities, so you may easily find new jobs in a very short period of time. And the flip side, if you have a job, before I concluded that probability of homelessness is decreased. By increasing the number of supply of affordable housing, improving the quality of existing housing, and give rental assistance to those who need it. Number third one is improving the employment rate. You know, employment is the main pathway to out of homelessness. By increasing the opportunity, especially in those area who contain minimum level of skill. So by providing opportunities, this issue will be eradicated. The other point is that to support the people who are addicted. So I earlierly said that the addiction is a very major problem of homelessness. So to provide or access to good treatment and the supporter services can also help to address their addictions and prevent homelessness. The other one is raise minimum wages. In that area where the minimum wages can't afford the rent of houses, so the government or authorities they must raise their wages to afford the rent of the houses. And the other platform, the other factor that affect should forward to play their role is the social media. You know, today's world is the social media world. So if we raise the voice of the homelessness people, or combine the funds for those people, or reach the voice to the high authorities of homelessness, so I think it will be play a very vital role in the eradication of this problem. So in conclusion, in a nutshell, I can say that the homelessness is a very major and very serious issue. Is a very serious issue in today's life. So the government and the high authorities are responsible to make such plans, to make such programs, to regard this problem. Thank you very much, sir. If you have any question, you may ask me.
Okay. So the first question would be regarding your topic. If you become a prime minister, so what step will you take for such kind of people?
Sir, can you repeat the question, please?
I'm saying that if you become a prime minister of your country, so what kind of steps you will take for such kind of people?
Sir, if I will become the prime minister of Pakistan, so first of all, rights of dead people. I have no capacity to give the permanent houses, so at least I will give him shelters that save him from cold in winter and from hot in summer, inshallah. I hope so.
All right, that is fine. You know, there would be some people who would be saying the same thing, that like, you know, I'll tell you one thing, that there would be some people who are sitting on a high position and you are not giving them good money. So what do you think about them? Like, you know, you said that the salary should not be increased, or they should be given minimum salary or minimum wages.
Yes,
so
sir.
I don't think so that, sir, they would work on those positions then, what they deserve.
Yes, sir, of course, sir. Of course, of course. But then people need more hardworking, because if they jobs one time, so they double their hardworking. They must job at the other authorities. You mean that he does not much money to pay their rent. So they should more hardworking. So they should do more hard work to pay their rent.
All right, that's great. Now I'll be having a question from you regarding your essay.
Okay,
so the first word that you have written in your essay is resistant. What is the meaning of resistant?
So resistant means show opposition to something.
All right. Another word which you have written over here is the phrase outside the box. What is the meaning of outside the box?
Sir, outside the box is actually an idiom which means to express the ideas, to explore the ideas that are creative, unusual, and that are not limited by the rules and tradition.
Okay, what is the meaning of stainless?
Stainless means spotless, or that thing which is free from mental and physical abuse or wrongdoing.
All right, that is fine. And another word which you have used here is strive. What is the meaning of strive?
So, strive mean make the things that that you will mean struggle or try.
All right, that's fine. According to your point of view, who do you think could lead or run the country better? Young generation, youngsters, or the aged people?
Can you repeat the question, please?
I'm saying that according to your point of view, who could run the country very
yes.
well? The aged people or the youngsters?
Sir, in my opinion, that age is not so much is not a factor of issue. I say, in my point of view, that they're people who are very much experienced, so they could run administration very well. They can run a country very well because they face a lot of problems and they know how to run and how to tackle all the problems, all the situation, all the circumstances.
All right, that is great. Okay, could you please let me know the source which you have written in your essay? So from where did you pick up?
Sir, actually, I am due to my political background, so I have some social experience. So at that time, the source which was that was my mind. So at that time, I thought and I wrote.
All right. If you had more things to express in your essay, what would be there, and what stopped you to not write those things?
Sir, actually, already the examiner gave me a very lot of time. So I think I complete all the thoughts in that essay. There will be no more words.
All right, that is great. Now we shall move to the last part, which is non-picture. And this picture, I'll be showing you a picture on which you are supposed to talk.
Okay, sir.
You have 20 seconds. You can start.
Well, the picture that I see in my screen is about a conversation of three people. The one who is standing wearing a black coat and wearing a black dress, having a bag in her hand, in his hand, sorry, bag in his hand. The other two people which are sitting in on the chair and looking so professional. The one is very serious. The right The one who is on the left side of the man who are standing, they are very serious and looking toward the back, while the other which are the right side of the person who are standing is very calm, cool, and sitting on the chair very and enjoying very freshly. I think I suppose in his hand there is a pin. Actually, in my point of view, the person who is standing and his bag in his hand, he put some soil and or he put some goods. He collects some goods from other places. So if he comes count the men who are very cool and calm and pointing and he the bin on his hand, he count his bag number, say whole time he come to the good space. So and the man who are capturing the picture, he is also very cool and want to record every moment of this happening.
Okay, that's great. So thank you. You will get your official result within 48 hours. Thank you.